Hello guys, welcome to our dream channel and hope you guys are all doing good. So lately we have been receiving a lots of messages on how to code in Java. So today we are just going to kickstart a simple Java program on how to print in Hello World, and this will be a good starter for your Java career. So people from various backgrounds can get benefited out of this, like either students, university students, or people who are trying to learn Java. So this video will be a very good starting point for all those people. So the basic things that you need for setting up your Java environment and to code in Java is, first you need to have JDK, which is nothing but Java Development Kit. So if you're going to program in Java, we need to have this Java Development Kit installed in your system. I have already installed in my Windows system, but if you want to install, you can just search JDK in Google and it'll end up in oracle.com JDK downloads. So in that, you can just download the package based on your operating system. If you are using Apple, that is a Mac OS, you have to go with the package for Apple. And if you are using the Windows system, you have to go with JDK Windows, whether it is 64-bit or whether it is 32-bit, depending upon your system configuration. So my system is a Windows 64 operating system, so I have downloaded JDK 64-bit thing. And secondly, we need to have an editor to write your Java program. So there are various ways by which you can write your Java program. Like you can even write it in a notepad, but it becomes very difficult from a developer perspective. It becomes very difficult to manage the code. So even in the IT industry, we normally go with the editors. So there are some famous editors which we can use for Java. Either it can be Eclipse, or you can go with NetBeans, or you can go with IntellijJ. All these three are some of the most popular editors for Java programming currently in the industry. And you can choose any one of those. And if you don't have any idea about any of these editors, and if you're just a beginner for programming, I prefer to use Eclipse, since I am experienced in that, and I used to work in Eclipse, so I'm choosing Eclipse for it. I've already installed Eclipse on my system, but if you want to install it, so just you can give Eclipse a download for Java programming, and you will end up in this particular download space where you can download the Eclipse ID for Java developers or Java EE developers, and based on your operating system, you can choose. And let me launch my Eclipse. And before that, I have told you about the JDK. So once you I have my JDK over here. So this is my downloaded JDK. If you install this particular JDK, it will get into your program files Java, and your JDK will get installed over here, and your JRE will be inside this JDK. People often confuse between JDK and JRE. JDK is nothing but a Java Development Kit, and JRE is the Java Runtime Environment. If you are going to program in Java, you need to have a JDK in your system, which will have all the packages related to programming. And if you are going to run your program, that is, if you are going to run the compiled Java program, you need to have the Java Runtime Environment, so which is nothing but a sort of a JVM which is going to execute your program. And once this is done, we need to set up our Java environment. So it is nothing but setting up your environment variables. So just if you type in environment over here, you will get an option called as edit the system environment variables. Just give an enter and click on the environment variables, and in that you will have a variable with the name path. So try to edit that particular variable, and in that try to add what is your JDK path. So this is the path which needs to be set for your Java path variable, which is nothing but for us, for me, it has got installed in C program files Java JDK 1.8.192, and inside that you will have a bin folder. So this is the Java path variable which needs to be set in your system. And this is a Windows variable. To take into effect, mostly you might have to restart your system, but sometimes it works even without that. So if it is not getting reflected, try to restart your system once, since it's in Windows system variable. So once that is done, so now your Java environment is done. So you have your JDK, you have your JRE, and the path variable is set. And you've also installed Eclipse, and now you have launched your Eclipse. As soon as you click on the Eclipse, it will try to open a workspace. So it goes into workspace is nothing but it is a physical folder in your system where all the programs will go and get saved. So just use the default workspace and give OK. And your Eclipse will get launched. I have used the Eclipse in Neon version. It's one of the latest versions of Eclipse. So there are various versions of Eclipse like Neon, Kepler, and lots of other stuff. I go with Neon since it provides additional features. So now we're going to start with a simple program called as an Hello World program. So you have two things, a package explorer or a navigator. So we can use any of this. Right click over there, okay, and a new Java project. And you can just give a name for your project. It is an Hello World project for us. And it will ask you to use a project specific JRE. If you have installed your JDK, it will come pre-populated. And you can just finish your project. And now that the project has got created, and it will have the JRE, whatever the Java's specific jars will get into your project. And you'll have your SRC folder. SRC folder is nothing but it is a folder where all your code is going to get into. And if you open your navigator window, it will be much more easier to see. You'll have the settings, you'll have the bin folder, and you'll have your SRC folder. And your navigator tab will start showing up. And inside this SRC folder, now we're going to start writing a program. So right click on the SRC folder, a new class. In Java, everything is going to be in terms of classes, and it will open a dialog where you have to specify the name of your class. So let it be an Hello class, and don't forget to check the public static void main string args path. So checking this is nothing but if you check this out, so your hello.java has got created, and this public static void main will come by default. If you have not checked it, this part will not come up. It will be something like this. You can even type in, that's not a problem. The main use of public static void main is nothing but it tells your compiler like where exactly your program is going to start. It always searches for the main method. And other two important steps that you are going to check it is, go to Windows preferences and check what is the compiler path. So when you go to the Java, you will see the compiler. So our Java, we are using the Java 1.8 version. So since our JDK is 1.8, which means that you're using the Java 8 version, so here it should be 1.8. and installed JREs, it is nothing but it should point to your JDK so that it will take the JREs. If these two things are not properly mapped, your program will not run in your system. So these are two additional checks that you have to do. So after that, so now we have your class and you have your main method. In that, you can just type in system.out.println and you can print in hello world. And you can just save your thing. So system.out.println. So just you have to just copy paste this particular thing, and the syntax you have to maintain the same. It is case sensitive. So as you start with cap.out.println, and whatever the text that you type in within this double quotes will get printed in your console. Now you have to just right click on this particular Java class, run as a Java application. It will run and it will print whatever has been written in your system.out.println statement. And in addition to that, we are going to see some of the basic arithmetic operations. Like if you are going to do some basic arithmetic operations, I've already typed in some sample code. So we have data types, integer, double, float. And for doing a basic addition operation or the sum, we are using two variables, A and B. And the sum of those two variables is going to be stored in C. So A equals 10, which means that 10 is a value which is going to be assigned to the variable A, and 15 is a value which is going to be assigned to the variable B. Sum of A and B is going to be assigned to the variable C. And we're going to print the sum as sum of. So if you are going to print a value in system.out.println, you have to just to print in what is the variable name. So now A will be 10 over here. And whatever the string that you're going to print in, that is a hard-coded string, that should come within the double quotes. If you're going to combine both, it should be like sum of should be in double quotes. And since you're going to include a value, and it has to be separated by the plus, and should be within the double quotes, plus B is C. So now if you run this program, the output will look like sum of 10 and 15 is 25. A, which has a value 10, and B, which has a value 15, and the resultant will be stored in C, which is nothing but 25. And similarly, you can even do some of the difference operation, that is a subtraction. So here similarly, D has a value 15, E has a value 10, and F has the difference of D and E, and we are printing it as difference of D and E is 5. 15 minus 10 is 5. And you can also do a multiplication. So multiplication in Java, we use hash trick as the operator for doing multiplication. So product of 15 and 10, it's going to be 150. You can run this out. So product of 15 and 10 is 150. And similarly, if you want to do division, you can use the slash operator, which is nothing but the division operator. So run as a Java application. On dividing 15 by 10, we have got 1. The reason being, all the data types of these variables are integer. If you want the exact value to the decimal point, it should be in double. So double is a data type for storing in decimal values. So if you are running as Java application, you will get the exact value as 1.5. So to reiterate whatever we have seen over here, so for running a basic Java program in your system, you need to install Java Development Kit. You can use any version of Java, but it's better to use the latest version. So even 1.9 has come, but I go with 1.8 since I have already installed 1.8. And you need to have any of the editor in your system. Either you can go with Eclipse or NetBeans or IntellijJ. We went with Eclipse. And you need to set up your Java path variable. And inside your environment variables, path, edit, add your JDK bin folder in your Java path. After that, launch your Eclipse, create a Java project, and create a class by checking in public static void main, and system.out.println is a command which helps you to print the text the same way as you have entered within the double quotes. And you can do some of the basic arithmetic operations and like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. And for printing in the values, you have to print the variable name as is, but it should not be inside the double quotes. It should be outside the double quotes. Whatever is there inside the double quotes will be printed as is. And for multiplication, you have to use the asterisk operator, and for division, you have to use the slash operator. And if you want the values to be printed to the decimal values, then you should have the data type as float or double. If you have any questions, don't forget to post your questions in the comment, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to this channel if you find the content informative. We'll keep you posted with other informative videos. Thank you.